Chapter 1. The adventure begins. It was a lovely day in June when three boys were, were walking across the sands between Penforth and Bywater looking for adventure. Funnily enough, their names were Tom, Dick and Harry. And Tom had heard that in one of the houses nearby there lived a man who might be able to put them on the right road.
I think that must be the house.
So I observe, but I don't remember inviting you, and I'm very busy.
We heard you were writing a new book, and we thought you might like to write about us again.
Oh, you did you? Well, as a matter of fact, I... Sit down a minute.
It's rather fun meeting old friends again.
Now, what put the idea into your head?
We're looking for adventure.
Like David Watchycallin, in Kidnap, or like...
Just a minute.
We don't mind a bit of danger.
Well, you can't say fairer than that. Are you ready to start at once?
Yes, sir.
Anybody got a watch? No? Well, you better take this one, because time is going to play an important part in this story. No squabbling. I shall want you to take some other things, too. These binoculars, and mind you take care of them. I'll give you a rucksack to carry everything in. By the way, I suppose you can't ride bicycles, can you?
Of course we can.
Good. You'll find some in the shed. Just a minute. You don't know where you're going yet. Can any of you read a map?
I think I can, sir.
Good. Then come and look here. Now, we are here. You see this spot? You're making for that tower, just there. If you have any difficulty in finding it, you can get up to the top of this hill. You can get a good view all around. You will have to start out along this road through the village. Then bear left, just after you pass the thatched cottages. Go straight on until you come to a village with a church clock. And when you get there, it should be about 20 minutes to 7. That means you've got no time to waste.
We better look at the map first.
Aren't we going the right way?
We don't want to go up this hill for nothing.
Don't you know the way? I thought you said you could read a map.
So I can, but we've got to get our bearings first. We better get up the hill like the author said. We ought to be able to see the tower from there. Glasses.
Well, let's have a look.
Just a minute. Yes, I think it is.
Well, let's have a look. Yes, that's the tower, all right.
Just like he told us.
This is the best adventure we've ever had.
Yes, and if we don't hurry up, we've had it. We've got exactly 18 minutes to get over to the tower.
Which way?
The road down should be over there.
That's better than going up.
We've got to keep our eyes open.
Yes, but what are we looking for?
There's the tower anyway. We'd better get up there.
Just a minute. We can't all go. You stay down here and keep an eye on the road while Harry and I work our way up to the tower. And keep down.
There's nothing much going on here. Better go down again.
No, Dick's down there. We'll keep near the tower. Look out. Someone coming here, too. Let's get up there.
That's you, Badger. Okay, Spike.
You're all right. Seen anything?
No, but I wish the boss was here. He'd know how to handle it.
I know how to handle it, and so do you. And what's more, you better prove it before you meet him at Southampton tomorrow. He's coming on the Queen Mary. You've got to be there.
Well, I wasn't cut out for this sort of thing.
Well, you better be cut out for it if you want the boss to cut you in.
All right, come on.
Better make a dash for it.
Dirty paces from this tree, 40 from that one. secret, Martin. If it leaks out, we're finished. That's why we've got to deal with this chap Baker today.
Double-crossed us, eh?
Well, he tried to. Look out. There's somebody coming now. That's him, all right.
Walk right into the trap. Are you sure you're all right? No bones broken?
No, I'm all right. Just give me a minute to get my breath. It was clever of you to catch Peggy. You naughty girl. She never does that sort of thing in the usual way. Backfire or something startled her. Then I lost my stirrup of all things. Who's this? Can we help?
Yes. Tie the mare to the tree. Can you do it?
Yes, sir.
Did either of you get the number of the car, the motorcycle?
No. But we know the name of the driver. We think he's a crook.
I couldn't agree with you more.
I feel better now. I'm really very grateful to you. I think I could ride her back now.
Nonsense. I'm driving you home.
But I'm perfectly fit to ride.
Yeah, maybe, but you're not going to. Do you live near?
A good few miles away.
And you've got someone to send for the horse?
Yes, but...
Oh, right. That settles it. Oh, by the way, do you mind if the boys come along too? I've got one or two questions I'd like to ask them.
No, of course not.
Touch it.
My father. I'm afraid he's not very well.
Down, put it down.
Come along, boys. Tea.
Who are they?
Now, you say you saw these three men and can recognize them again?
I'm sure we could.
But you don't know which of the three fired the revolver shot?
No, but it must have been either Spike or the man with him, because they were higher up the hill and nearer to us than the third man.
That's right. The other chap was nearer Dick, down on the road.
You didn't get the number of the car or the motorcycle, I suppose.
I got the number of the car.
Good.
Oh, I forgot it.
Never mind, they'd have changed the number for certain.
But I marked one of the wheels.
Oh, that is a good idea. How do we know where to start to look?
But we do. We know where Spike will be tomorrow.
Where?
Going to Southampton to meet the boss, whoever he is.
Listen, boys. You may have stumbled on something rather important. How would you like to take a trip to Southampton tomorrow to see if you can point out this man Spike to me?
This all sounds very mysterious, but I think I can throw some light on these men you're talking about. I have one or two valuable racehorses here. In fact, one of them's running on Thursday. I expect these men were sneaking around hoping to get some information.
But what about the shot?
We're not absolutely certain it was one. It might have been a backfire.
No, I don't think so. I'm afraid these men are after something much more serious than racing tips.
Oh. Well, if the boys really have got some useful information, don't you think they should go to the police?
Well, in a way they have.
What do you mean?
Well, I'm what the fiction writers call a flatfoot.
A detective.
And you really think this is important? What's happened today?
Well, men don't fire revolvers at one another for fun in this country. Obviously, our friends Spike and Co. don't live by the rules, so that means I must know more about them. Unfortunately, I've never seen them, so it's no good my going to Southampton alone. That's why it seems very much as though the whole thing depends on these boys. All right, boys, now get along.
Thank you for the tea.
Let's go and see them off, shall we?
Okay, thanks.
Won't be
long.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye. If you're not back in 2 hours' time, we'll send out a search party for you. Won't we, Diana?
They're bright, aren't they?
They are indeed.
I think perhaps we'd better go in.
I hope this isn't going to turn out to be a love story.
Don't be daft, Harry. Diana's pop. What were you doing?
Looking upward.
What for?
Because I like it. Look upward and mark a steadfast stars. Not one from duty wanders. That's why I look up. See? Goodbye.
What did he say? Look upward, and mark the steadfast stars. Not one from duty wanders. I like that.
Queer bird, isn't he?
He's not the only one.
Thank you.
Here's the car, Governor. We'll be away in no time.
Good, I'm tired. Dad, you arrange about the luggage?
Oh, yes, that's all been attended to. Be there soon after you. Away without a soul spotting us. I tell you, if you want a job done, we're the boys to do it for you.
You talk too much. How long will it take us to get there?
Oh, inside an hour.
Be careful, you fool.
Hurry. Hurry. Seen anything?
No.
Well, everybody's off. I wonder where taken Mr. Michael is.
We know where he'll be. Back in Mr. Anna's cottage. Come on.
Here you are, Governor. The roadhouse is through that gate. The path brings you in the back way.
Get away as quick as you can. Telephone through to K7 and report to me tonight.
Telephone handy?
Yes, sir. In there to the left.
Thanks. Put in 4 gallons, will you?
Right.
Well, Dick, I think you put up a jolly good show. It's bad luck you didn't see the boss.
He saw his boots.
How about the car number?
No, our only hope is to trace the spot where the boss got out.
Do you think you can find the place again?
We'll have a jolly good try. Dick says that it's 10 minutes car ride from the petrol station, and he knows the rough direction, so that we should be able to follow that up until we find a thatched cottage with 3 chimneys. And then we'll be able to evolve a plan of action.
How far is 10 minutes in a car?
Or on winding roads and allowing for Spike's mania for speed, about 6 miles.
When do we start looking?
Tomorrow morning.
Had any luck? Seen Harry?
No.
Well, look, we'd better get back to the road. I'll go this way and you go that, and we'll meet down there. After all, must have gone another way around. Looks as if he's after something. We'd better follow him up.
Thank you. Hey, what do you think you're doing?
Nothing. I was only looking for her.
Come on inside. I want to talk to you.
Corey's gone in.
Didn't you see him signal? We'd better hang around for a bit. He'll get a message to us somehow.
Snooping about the place in that manner? Now tell me, what were you up to?
Well, I was looking for...
Oh, the page's job. Is that what you were after?
Yes, that's it. I was after the job.
The advertisement says applicants for the job should apply at the staff entrance. Do you usually look for jobs through a window?
Well, I wanted to see what the place looked like first.
Very smart, aren't you? All right, go up to room 7. And if the uniform of the last boy fits you, I'll see about giving you a trial.
Okay.
Don't say okay to me. Learn to say yes, sir. Or you won't be here very long.
Yes, sir. Which way do I go?
Up those stairs.
Ah. What did all that mean?
Don't you see? He's got a job as a page.
A page? How's that going to help?
That'll help a lot. He's right in the enemy's camp.
But he can't do much by himself.
You never know. Anyway, Michael'll know what to do.
Michael acted quickly. Tomorrow, they would go to the hotel as guests. He had managed to get a message to Harry to tell him of their plans, and Harry was busy keeping his eyes open for any information that might be useful to Michael. But it was not easy, for that fierce-looking porter seemed to be always on his heels.
Page! Come on! Get a move on. Room service in number 6.
Okay.
Come back. What did I tell you yesterday?
Sorry, sir, it won't happen again.
See that it doesn't.
Okay.
What?
Sorry, sir, yes, sir. You sent for me, sir.
Get me some sealing wax and bring it up immediately.
Yes, sir.
What would you like to eat, Tom?
Can I look at the menu, please? I'm afraid it's no good. I only eat in English.
Perhaps you'd better let Michael order for you.
That's better. We'll get some of that. Can't see Harry anywhere.
Don't be a gump. Remember what Michael said? We haven't to recognize him, even if we see him.
Poor Harry. I expect he's in the kitchen cleaning knives and forks.
Or peeling potatoes.
Miss! Excuse me, but you dropped this.
How silly of me. Thank you. What's your name?
Harry, miss.
Well, Harry, maybe one day I'll be able to do something for you.
Thank you very much, miss.
Excuse me, miss. I'll show you the way to the artist's room.
Would you care to dance, Miss Diana?
Can you dance?
Well, I think I can do that.
All right, I'll risk it.
Enjoying themselves, aren't they?
Tell Michael to call me over.
Thank you, Miss Diana.
Sit down, Tom. I think they did pretty well, didn't you, Dick?
Not bad. That's bad. I thought we were very good.
What's it all about?
I want you to call him over.
You want me, sir?
Yes, I want you to look up and address me. I'll write the name down.
Very good, sir. What's the idea?
The idea of getting Raymond's address? Oh, I tried to look him up tomorrow. Being watched.
What are you doing now? Give it to me. Where is he? Didn't I tell you not to move from here? There are people in the restaurant to deal with those matters. There's no bother about it. What's the table number? Oh, you know that, do you? An idea you're not going to be here very long. What's that? Don't forget, move from here and you'll move a long way away tomorrow. Get over to those doors.
Just a lucky chance. Don't worry about it.
How often have I told you what happened to Carter was situated?
Look, Alice, let me come and
you
see
you. You stay where you are. Well, you know, they may know who you are.
Call it.
Washington. Nothing.
Yes, sir? Well, maybe you'd like to move somewhere else.
That will delay my plan. We need every hour now.
Well, I wonder if, I suppose, as usual, I must have all the things.
Let us imagine that these interfering people could come to the right ship.
You stay with Diana. Dick and I are going to investigate. We're not back in a quarter of an hour. Telephone for the police. They like the shoes the man who landed at Southampton was wearing?
Yes, I think so.
Right. We'll take a chance on him.
Come on.
Stay where you are.
I don't think I have the pleasure.
The one or two questions I want to ask you.
By all means, by all means. However, you'll pardon me if I question the regularity of your approach.
I have all the authority I need.
Pity. I thought I might help. You see, I happen to be the only local magistrate in these parts. My identity card. If you have any further doubts, there are at least 10 people in the dining room downstairs who can confirm my statement.
I can only offer you my humble apologies.
Say no more. However, if I may give you a piece of sound advice, don't let your enthusiasm outrun your discretion.
They've gone. The shoes have gone.
Hmm.
I think we'd better it.
Well, in a way, yes. But in a way, no.
Well, what now? Advance everything 48 hours.
Come on, Tom, we've all got an hour to get to Ascot.
Oh, well, that's torn it.
What's up?
Puncture. You two'd better go on. I'll catch you up.
Perhaps Miss Diana would take you in the horse box.
Don't be silly. That's the whole idea. Mr. Michael wants us to go on our own. Don't worry, I'll be there in time for the first race.
Okay, see you later. Uh-oh, here comes your friend Bob.
Good morning, boys.
Good morning.
What are you doing?
Mending a puncture.
Oh, I know.
You didn't by any chance stick a pin in my tire, did you?
Pin? They don't let me have a pin. They don't even let me have a razor. Don't forget. Look upwards. Here it is. I found it.
But Tom had no patience with Pop in his queer ways just then. Already, Diana was setting off for Ascot with her horse, and Sunstroke certainly looked in very good form as he watched them coax him into the box. He might easily win, but what is the good of that? It was very doubtful whether Tom could even get there in time for the race. Fate seemed very cruel. Still, he managed to give Diana a smile of encouragement as she drove away. And in reality, fate had played right into his hands. For this delay was going to give Tom the best adventure of them all. But he didn't know that, as he prepared to set off, determined at least to keep an eye on Miss Diana while Michael was away on his important business in London.
I'm afraid I don't quite understand, sir.
Well, the position is this. My colleagues and I have been working on one phase of a very important discovery. And the secrecy of that discovery is of paramount importance. Now, we don't know the names of all the people associated with us, but our authority is derived from the highest quarters. Now, the full picture can only be obtained by reference to that authority. And I happen to know that that cannot be accomplished before tomorrow morning. So, meanwhile, we'll give you all the help we can.
I'm very grateful.
Now, will you ask questions, or shall I give you the facts as we know them?
I should like to know the facts, sir, in a language fit for the uninitiated.
Well, leaving out technical details, I think I can tell you all we know with a very few words. Did you ever hear of a ray that would stop aeroplane engines?
Not schoolboy magazine stuff, sir.
Yes, I'm afraid so. But it's not schoolboy magazine stuff any longer. To extend the range and make the ray an effective and devastating weapon is now a practical possibility.
Hence the international rivalry.
Exactly. Before we started work, experiments were so planned that one man, and one man only, had a complete working knowledge of the ray.
Who is he?
I can't tell you that because we don't know. He communicates with us and we with him. He flies a specially equipped plane over a given area and makes recordings from a ray of diminished power.
Oh, one last word. Does this diagram mean anything to you?
I'm afraid not.
I'm very grateful for your help. I do now know at least what I'm looking for.
Good.
What's up?
I'm glad you turned up. There's something wrong here. Give us a hand, will you? It's the axle, I'm afraid. You look after him and I'll look after the girl.
Fred!
Nice work. Okay, Charlie, back her. You're all clear.
That's not Fred. Hey, come back.
Charlie, hold it. Get her out of here as quick as you can.
You don't, Nora?
Shut up.
Good.
The moment you look at her,
don't bash her about. Not good, did you?
Shut up, you.
Careful, not careful. Have you got it, George?
Get the entrance open. Jump to it. Push that thing away. We can get through there.
Yeah, give it to me. I'll take it.
Now, Charlie, get the horse to Ascot as quick as you can. You'll have to go like hell if you're going to be there before the big race.
I'll let you ride.
Give us a hand there.
Okay, Charlie, you get Guy.
Didn't it?
Yes, but where's Miss Diana? Have you seen her?
No.
We can't find Tom either.
Why, didn't he come with you?
No, he had a function and we left him behind. He said he was coming after.
And he's not turned up yet? Now, look here, boys. I'm worried about him and Miss Diana. I'm going to see if the trainer knows anything. You can see if you can find the horse box in the park. I'll be with you in a minute.
See what he can find from looking at a horse box. Look out.
Is this the horse box?
Yes, this is it.
Good. Now the point is, did Diana travel in it or not?
Didn't our trainer know anything?
No, he's as worried as I am. Hello. She's been here for certain. She was wearing this yesterday.
Perhaps something's happened to her.
Well, she wouldn't have missed the races intentionally.
Neither would Tom. Where's he got to?
That's right, Tom.
Perhaps he's with her.
Yes, that's what I'm hoping.
Hadn't we better go and find her?
Now, wait a minute. Let's get this straight. We know she left home in it.
Michael, here, quick. Here. Look here, and I'm sure that's a message from Tom.
Pop's poem? What's it mean? Who's Pop?
That's Diana's father.
Huh? Well, what's Pop's poem, then?
I don't know. Just a minute. What's that thing he's always saying?
What's the point?
What do you mean? Look up, what's something, something? I can't remember it.
Wait a minute. Say that again.
Look up, what's something, something? Look upwards.
Look upwards. I believe you've got it. Look, get up on the top and see if you can find anything to help us. A message or something. Can you see anything?
Yes, there's something here. It looks like a map.
Yes, go on.
It's on a gate. Oh, no, it's a level crossing.
Go on.
Then there's two sort of palm trees on a castle.
Yes.
No, a tower.
Two trees and a tower. The tower. That was what the plan meant. Do you think you can make a copy of it on this?
Yes.
Right, you do that then, while I go and telephone. Meet me at the car as quickly as you can.
Put me through to Inspector Burrow as quick as you can. Oh, is that you, George? Mike here. Now, I want you to get your men round to this place straight away, near Bilton. Yes, it's rather more serious than I thought. I'm afraid they've got the girl. And one of the boys, too. Yes, we've got no time to lose.
Is the girl secure?
Couldn't be tied up by a parson.
Good. If she becomes hysterical, gag her.
You've got it wrong, boss. She ain't that sort. This dame's like the horses she breeds. She's got spirit.
In my country, we have a variety of ways for breaking spirit. Some are very ingenious, and they usually get results, you see. We're very persevering.
I hope it won't come to that.
Why not? It may be very interesting.
What happens now?
You go and watch for Kelly. Let me know the moment he arrives. You go outside and keep everyone away. And keep an eye on the girl. Take very good care of her.
He should have run a concentration camp during the war.
He did. Come on.
When it all started that first day.
Yes, there's the tower of the monkey puzzle trace.
Yes, up there. Come on.
No fool over here. Here, I'll tie him up with this.
Father.
Why are you sitting there like that? Don't you think it's rather silly?
Oh, shut up, you.
Really, I think this is a very silly game. I don't wish to be a spoil sport, but I'd much rather play with my little aeroplane.
Good. Our little party is almost complete.
Will you start on the girl first?
No, I think we'll leave them alone for a little while. Perhaps the soft tones of your daughter may persuade you to come to your senses. Otherwise, we may induce her to sing to you.
You know exactly what the information is we want, so you'd better decide to give it to us quietly. Nobody will ever find you here.
I leave you alone for a little while now, but don't worry. I shall be back.
Diana, I'm sorry I got you into this.
Father, you're...
Sane, yes, my dear. I've never been better in my life. One day I'll explain to you why I had to adopt disguise and deceive even you. But that must wait. There's something more important than either of us at stake now.
I'm beginning to understand. You have an important invention?
The work is only partly mine. Unfortunately, I'm the only man who has the key to the working of the whole group.
But you won't tell them.
My dear, it's not going to be as simple as that. You can guess what they intend to do to us. Well, we shall have to prove that we're as strong as thousands of men and women who suffered during the war.
I'll try.
I should attempt to outwit them. The time factor is important to these men. They must deliver their information by tomorrow. Now, if I can cause a delay, there's a hope for us. But if I fail, well, we must do our best.
Is there no hope of our being rescued?
There's always that hope, but we mustn't count upon it too much. Who will guess that we're here?
Shh. Shh. It's all right. I'm coming down.
Tom, do be careful. The crooks are just outside. What is that up there?
It's the air shaft. Goes through a long way. I heard your voices at the other end, so I took a chance.
How did you get here? Does Michael know we're here?
He does. If Dick and Harry are the staff, just me look.
No, it's so good. We can't get in here. No way to open it. Lee, there must be a secret lever somewhere.
Well, what about that place in the heather, where Tom and I saw the man?
Well, that's our last hope.
What are we going to do?
We shall have to get out of here as quickly as possible. This used to be an underground factory during the war. I've had my plant here ever since.
Is there another way out?
There was, but we had it blocked. We shall have to hide until help comes. It'll be useless to try the main entrance. I think they'll have a job to find us.
I'm sure Michael won't let us down.
Of course he won't, my dear. Was this the spot?
Just about here.
Well, you keep watch over there, and you over there, Dean, while I search around.
What do you mean they've gone, blast you?
Don't you reason up and crane this damn rabbit warren? They can't be far away.
Why not smoke them out, boss?
Because we smoke ourselves out as well. Come on, let's get going.
Harry, look, I found something.
Can't go on like this. They're bound to find us in the end.
If we can reach the room we're heading for, we can beat them yet.
Come on. Stand back, boys. Better let me go first. And watch your step. Look out for booby traps. We've got to get down a long way yet.
They must be here somewhere. Come on.
We're all right now. Slam the door. This is the safest place in the world. Nobody will find us here. Everything seems all right. It's all a little secret.
I think you're wrong, Professor. Thank you, Professor. No doubt it would be useful to smash the machine, but you've indicated its importance to me. That's all I need to know.
You can't get it out of the country.
Can't I? That's just where you're wrong. All that remains now is to write the final chapter on a distinguished scientific career.
Look out, Doctor! Thank you.
Special plane fitted to receive the signals from the ray machine.
What do you mean?
The machine is in the plane with him. Now, if I can gauge the time correctly, I can start the ray motor by remote radio control. And being near the panel, it'll bring the plane down.
We'll win yet.
You got a watch?
Yes.
It's been gone about 2 minutes. Listen. You hear that? He's just taken off. Watch the seconds. Watch the rays. Now, if I can get them opposite to each other, with the aeroplane in between them...
What happens then?
The plane will be out of control. Then it'll crash.
Father, do you think you can do it?
I'm going to try the most important experiment in my life.
Yes?
Yes.
Nearly.
No. Oh. Yes, yes. Not quite. Never mind, we'll try again.
Yes,
yes, nearly. Yes, nearly. Well, no, 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 it's good. We've still got 3 seconds to go. Here it comes, here it comes. Yes, 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 yes.
You've got it.
We've got it. We've got it.
It turned out to be a love story after all.
Yes, boys, it was a love story. But it was a good adventure story, too, wasn't it? You didn't let me down, not for an instant. I hope I didn't let you down. Perhaps we shall all meet again one day. Goodbye, you chaps. Ciao, Tom. Bye-bye, Dick. So long, Harry. Bye-bye. Good luck to you.
Goodbye.